We began with Morning of Has Broken, of course, Phil playing that for us. It was written, the words were written by Eleanor Fargen, and the tune apparently is an old Gaelic one. It was first promulgated in 1931 and of course became a big hit later for Cat Stevens. We've been looking at the collection of and the generosity of people who have brought gifts for harvest, which are going to be taken now to the food bank to be shared out. And we thank them very much. At this time, it's no bad thing to remember that the call of Jesus is always that we should be generous, that we should share, and that we shouldn't turn a blind eye to the needs of others. People sometimes want to say, oh, well, what's the church got to do with politics? People often want to try and make out that Jesus just went around and said some rather nice things. But Jesus was very, very clear and unequivocal in his attitude to social justice and the fact that we're not called to be lukewarm, but we're called to be aglow with the Spirit. These are some words of Jesus. Do you suppose that I'm here to bring peace on earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. For from now on, a household of five will be divided, three against two and two against three. The father divided against the son against father, mother against daughter against mother, daughter-in-law against, again, mother-in-law against daughter-in-law against mother-in-law. He said again to the crowds, when you see a cloud looming up in the west, you say at once that rain is coming, and so it does. And when the wind is from the south, you say, it will be hot, and it is. Hypocrites, you know how to interpret the face of the earth and the sky. How is it that you do not know how to interpret these times? It's very important in the ministry of Jesus to realize that the things he is saying, although they are universally true and are the statements of the incarnate Son of God, they are also set in a particular time, and that's something that we have thought about together. Jesus was born into the world at a particular time, just like all of us. And the events and the circumstances, the history of the period of time in which he was born are addressed by him. He is born in a time of great turmoil within the country that he is born. They are occupied, they are suffering under the rulership of puppet kings, and always there is the menace and the power of the Roman Empire that is occupying them. There is great disquiet, and there is a great desire for God to act and for things to be put right. And so in that way, at the time of Jesus, there is not a great desire for peace. There is a desire for rebellion and revolt, for retribution and revenge. And as Jesus comes into conflict with the different groups who have all their own different interests, he is putting before them the fact that they're missing the point. That what they're going to do is going to lead to the destruction of Jerusalem, which indeed is what happened a few decades after Jesus himself was executed by them on the cross. Jesus can see the signs of the times, and the statements he is making are, yes, universal truths as to how human beings should behave and how the world is meant to be, but it's not some very, very thing that is some universal truth and therefore not applicable to any particular time or place. It has been true throughout the centuries. You could even say, and indeed surely we must say, it is true today. The truths that he sets before us of the need for human beings to open their eyes, to open their minds to see what is going on, are abundantly true. Yes, we may not be able to change the history or the shape of world politics, but we certainly are called to change the world insofar as it affects us. And this is part of doing that. This is part of saying, yes, God, I am very fortunate. Please help me to share with those who are not so fortunate at the moment. Please help me to show my gratitude for what I have by the way I use the resources that I have been given. That is practical Christianity. It is putting into practice the social concern that Jesus has. And more than that, as Christians, we need to open our eyes. Yes, we all want peace, but as Jesus is quite clear, the peace that he brings is not a peace that's built on turning a blind eye. It is a peace that is built upon doing the right thing. Not merely saying, oh, I haven't done anything terribly wrong, so I'm fine, but on looking at our lives and saying, well, what have I got? How fortunate am I? Do I really need all this? Could I not share it? Can I not practically look at ways in which I can help, care, and support other people? All too easily, we can be at peace by turning a blind eye, by pretending that what we can't see isn't happening. And yet that is not the option that Jesus gives to us. Jesus comes and challenges those in the political situation that he finds himself. And by the way he challenges them, he challenges every single generation and every single man and woman that ever was or is or will be with the same universal truths. Are your eyes open? Are you prepared to see and to do something about sin, evil, inequality, injustice? The same weaknesses, have run through human beings from the very beginning. The ones that Jesus addressed are the same that we are called to address. We are called to ask for his help and to see within his way of self-offering and self-sacrifice, even to death, a statement of our need to learn to fight against what is evil and wrong, to stand up against such forces, and to actively seek the paths of justice. And it is through justice and love and forgiveness that we do come to find peace. A poet who I've always enjoyed and been challenged by the poetry of was christened Woodbine William in the First World War, a chaplain to the forces, Studdock Kennedy. He wrote these words in a poem called Indifference. And it's no bad thing for us to think of. When Jesus came to Golgotha, they hanged him on a tree. They drove great nails through hands and feet and made a Calvary. They crowned him with a crown of thorns. Red were his wounds and deep. For those were crude and cruel days, and human flesh was cheap. When Jesus came to Birmingham, they simply passed him by. They would not hurt a hair of him. They only let him die. For men had grown more tender, and they would not give him pain. They only just passed down the street and left him in the rain. Still Jesus cried, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." And still it rained the winter rain that drenched him through and through. The crowds went home and left the streets without a soul to see. And Jesus crouched against the wall and cried for Calvary. As we, with generosity, bring our gifts to God, we remember those who are homeless. We remember those whom we are called to support. And we remember our need to bring peace through justice. We're now going to listen to a song which one of our choral singers, Chloe, has recorded for us. It's a song, I Wish You Peace. It was a Beatles song. It was written by Bernie Leadon, who was their guitarist, together with his partner at the time, who was Patti Davis, who was actually related to President Ronald Reagan. I think it comes at the time when the original Eagles were going separate ways, and it actually acts as a statement of how they need to put behind what is past and actively seek for good and to move forward.
Thank you. connect and let love flow on. I wish you the strength to let love flow on. I wish you the strength to let love go.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your generosity to us, and we pray that you will accept all our gifts, everything that we have. May we offer them to you without reserve, and we pray that you will use us to be your ambassadors, ambassadors of peace built upon truth and justice, upon mercy and love. Father, we pray for those who are in times of difficulty. We pray for those who will share this food. We pray for all those who are homeless. We pray for those who are hungry. Father, may we acknowledge our responsibility to show our love for you by the way in which we love our neighbour as ourself. Heavenly Father, in so doing, may we bring into our own part of the world your kingdom of justice, of peace, and love. We ask our prayers in Jesus' name. And the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon each one of you, your homes, and those you love, today and always. Amen.